Hello, welcome to NewsClick. Today, we are going to discuss about the current economic situation in the country. And we have with us A Soundararajan, CITU, Tamil Nadu. Welcome, sir.
Welcome.
The Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman says there is no sign of economic slowdown. But looks like the ground reality is different. What is your take on this?
Nirmala Sitharaman's statement is totally lying. And also, it is more obvious. It is no test, no examination, nothing is necessary to see that there is an economic slowdown. There is a sharp decline in every aspect of the economy, every aspect of the industrial development. Whether it is primary sector or secondary sector like manufacturing or service sector, every sector is in slowdown, in coming down, it is happening. How she is telling like this, it is surprise to me. Whether she is living in India or not, that is the my question. That is the thing.
Many companies in the automobile sector has closed down their production for some days. There are compulsory holidays, VRS, the deep impact on the contract labors. Maruti has shut down their plant for 2 days. Ashok Leyland has given compulsory holidays. So Tamil Nadu being the automobile sector of the country, what is the impact on this sector?
Yes, as far as Tamil Nadu is concerned, it is a main hub of automobile industry of India. But as well as Pune, as well as Gurgaon, those areas also having a lot of automobile industry. In Gujarat, in Ahmedabad, a lot of automobile industry. Automobile OEM, original equipment manufacturers, are there in all these areas. In northern India, in western India, in southern India, in Andhra Pradesh also it is there. And auto component manufacturers are there everywhere in India, everywhere. That is the small sector, micro, small, medium sector, MSME we will call it. Those sector is spread all over India. And also the supporting industry for producing the auto component, like foundries, steel manufacturing, tube manufacturing, strip manufacturing, all these industries are there, that is different. In Coimbatore, most of the industries like this, supporting industries are there in Coimbatore. In all these areas, there are loss of jobs taking place, there are closure of factories taking place, all non-permanent employees like contract, apprentice, trainees have been sent out. That crosses 3 lakh, 4 lakh rupees, according to the statement of the Auto Manufacturers Association, Auto Component Manufacturers Association. They are telling already 3 lakh people lost their job. Further, there is a possibility of 7 lakh more people may be losing their jobs. This is in automobile sector alone. This figure may cross that limit. 10 lakh limit. That is my assessment. Within 2-3 months, it will take place. So far, the loss of job is non-permanent workers in this industry. But the permanent workers are affected by way of giving layoff or non-performing day. Non-performing day, as you said, it is not 2-3 days. It is more than that. Almost all the major OEM companies, original equipment manufacturers like Ashok Leyland, like Daimler, like Nissan, Hyundai, Ford, every company has giving non-performing days more than 3 days per week. That has started. Permanent workers are being given non-performing day. They are starting that after some time, it will revive, the recovery will be there. Then you have to compensate all these days, they are saying, but they are paying salary. So the pinch is not yet realized by the workers themselves because they are getting their salary, the permanent workers are getting their salary, they are not being sent out so far. That is one aspect. Second is the automobile manufacturing or any other manufacturing, component manufacturing, is relying on steel, mainly steel and tubes and plastic raw materials and other things. All these companies are involved in producing all these things. More than 7,000 spare parts are there in a car or in a vehicle. All these 7,000 components are being produced by with these materials, plastic. These companies have been laid off. For example, in Tamil Nadu, there is one company, Tube Products of India. That mm-hmm. is Murugappa Kulumam. And that factory, now 3 days it is. As of now, it is 3 days per week. They have laying it off. Their companies in Tiruthani, in some other places are there. All those companies have been nearly 3 days, 4 days. It is, they are giving non-performing day. All permanent workers are already sent off. It is the status of Murugappa company. That is a big industrial thing. And then TVS, the another major thing. They have been laid off their workers in Lucas, in Wheels, India and other areas. They are supplying, besides automobile industry, they are supplying some other areas also. Even those areas have been also affected because of the economic slowdown. So the TVS factories in Padi area, that is, they are giving non-performing day for 3 days, 4 days like that. All permanent workers, nearly all permanent workers have been sent off. And then major industries like in Sriperumbudur, using this, they are producing, they are selling. Mm-hmm. Now, Nirmala Sitharaman last 23rd day, she have announced some stimulus, these, that 70,000 crore, mini budget she announced. In that, there is one aspect. That aspect is that within 30 days, the main producers, the manufacturers should give mm-hmm. the dues to the small small owners, small mm-hmm. company owners, entrepreneurs. Mm-hmm. That is one condition she put. That says the real picture, mm-hmm. that all these major companies are sucking the blood of the MSME companies. Mm-hmm. Because of that, because the interest burden and many other burdens, because they have closed the show, they have sent people out. That is happening in all these areas. That shows major producers, because of the slowdown, they have cut down the production. So, by that, the demand from the manufacturers has been come down. So, it affects the steel industry, it affects the tube industry, it affects the factory industry. That is one part. The other area is dealers. Mm-hmm. The main manufacturers like Hyundai and other, they get money from the dealers
okay.
in advance. Using that money, they are producing cars and selling
to the dealers.
And also, they won't give the dues, real shares to them within a limited period, stipulated period like that. They also affected. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of dealership, big dealership are there in Toyota, this you can see in Chennai and other areas, in rural areas also. More than, in my opinion, last week it is 263, it was appeared, but more than 400 dealership, big dealership. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying small one. Mm-hmm. Big dealership have been closed down. Stopped, totally closed.
Okay.
In every dealer shop, there will be more than 200 people will be working. If it is 400, you can count mm-hmm. it. Nearly 1 lakh people lost their job in dealership also.
Mm-hmm.
The indirect is the mechanics.
Mm-hmm.
The mechanics, the... And then one major industry is tire industry.
Mm-hmm.
The automobile and other thing.
Mm-hmm.
Tire industry, their godown is overflowing,
mm-hmm.
so they are not able to pull. All major tire companies all over India have given 3 days, 4 days, non-performing day compulsory. What happened is that this slowdown, this loss of income for lakh and lakh workers, stimulating the slowdown further. That is the stimulating factor to make the slowdown further sharp is the loss of income, those who are losing their job.
Mm-hmm.
This is the area where government is not able to see.
Mm-hmm.
They should see it in the perspective of the workers.
Mm-hmm.
Why the automobiles are not selling?
Mm-hmm.
Why? Nobody has become sannyasis, samyas.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody want to car, buy car and other thing. It needs money.
Mm-hmm.
It needs money means either their own savings or by getting loan.
Mm-hmm.
The other area is ILFS thing. Because of that, the non-banking companies
mm-hmm.
are not able to give loan to the buyers. The liquidity is not there, several things are. All these situations, complex situations, created a panic, created a what can I say, that it is not simply, you can't call it as a slowdown. Slowdowns means it may come up again,
right,
immediate future. CEOs of all big companies,
mm-hmm,
all are economic players, all are started talking. Never in my 20 years time, never this type of open statement from media and media, the CEOs are responding. They are reacting sharply that this is happening, this is happening, this is happening. But the government is trying to tell that nothing is there, don't worry. Telling that is the, I'm afraid because of this government's inept attitude and other thing. So the economic slowdown is overall. It is not specific to automobile industry.
Okay.
It is overall.
Okay.
The main reason is that the purchasing power is not there.
Okay.
You see, in the last 2 years alone, the IT sector, mm-hmm, in Chennai alone, in Tamil Nadu alone, they have sent more than 1 lakh people out of job. The pathetic thing is that the biscuit producer, Parle G, like that, they have started saying that even my 5 rupees biscuit is not selling.
Right.
Yes, 3 years, 3 months back, 3 months back it was selling like this. Now it is not selling like, mm-hmm, that. So this is the pathetic thing. Even the inner wares, the inner,
right,
wares. So they are saying that if inner wares selling is come down, that is the worst signal, they are saying.
That is happening
in India. So the problem is the purchasing power.
Mm-hmm.
The people should be given, they should be allowed to earn money, they should be given job, or those who are doing self-employment,
mm-hmm,
they should be given proper attention,
mm-hmm,
they should be given proper help. They are giving money to Modi's, they are giving money to big corporates.
Mm-hmm.
More than 10 lakh rupees they have spent in the last 3-4 years,
mm-hmm,
by way of tax concession, by way of bank thing. All these things being done for corporates. If these 10 lakh rupees have been sent,
mm-hmm,
spent for the remaining people other than corporates, Indian economy would have get boomed.
Mm-hmm.
See, the in the agricultural sector,
mm-hmm,
there is in the last 2-3 years, continuously drought, flood and other things are there. Our agricultural production has been coming sharply. For the last 6 years, they have not been given the supporting price.
Mm-hmm.
Supporting price is the one area where we can save agricultural agriculturalists. This government has not given that. They are cutting money. The money which is going to the common people,
mm-hmm,
that money has been continuously cutting down by budget after budget.
Mm-hmm.
These monies were given by Manmohan Singh government, the UPA government first.
Mm-hmm.
Take example, Manrega,
mm-hmm,
that is 100 days work, that has been collapsed now. More than 50,000 crores will come to rural people by way of that wages.
Mm-hmm.
Now, almost, already it was 75,000 crore.
Mm-hmm.
It has been come down to 50,000 crore. Budgetary allotment itself only 50,000 crore.
Mm-hmm.
Now, even that has not been spent regularly.
Mm-hmm.
In many areas, people are not given that work. It is it. So, if that money is not coming, immediately, what it means? Some several thousand crores of rupees are not coming to the hands of the work people,
mm-hmm,
and it is not going to the market.
Mm-hmm.
Then that is one reason for the market. If the farmers of,
mm-hmm,
India,
mm-hmm,
is being given the support,
mm-hmm,
price in the last 6 years, even if it is 1% or 2%,
mm-hmm,
that will be equal to 1 lakh crore rupees or 2 lakh crore rupees.
Mm-hmm.
That money, where it will go? It won't go to Swiss bank.
Mm-hmm.
It will only come to the market. All these ways, all these things are blocked,
mm-hmm,
by this government's pro-corporate policy. So this is the main issue. The broad, more than 60-70 crore people who are involved in agricultural sector,
mm-hmm,
is being neglected. That is one area. Second, MSME producers,
mm-hmm,
small entrepreneurs. Small entrepreneurs are one area where they can save some money,
mm-hmm,
they can buy a scooter, they can buy a car, they can buy a thing that like that. They are in total doldrums. So all these things lead us to the slowdown.